dream, things can only get better. That's the right song to play before we speak to Angela Ferguson, I think, isn't it? Hello, Angela.
Hi, Gavin. How are you?
I'm great, thank you. And happy birthday for the other, was it a week ago or so?
Gosh, yes, it was. Big birthday. Yeah, yes. Me and Gary.
You and Gary Barlow, two Cheshire legends born on exactly the same day, back in 19...
Yeah, a few years ago now.
Yeah, just a few. Well, look, it's great to have you back on. It's been a few weeks since we last spoke. What are you up to with We Are Cheshire at the moment?
Yeah, well, we've been busy. I think, as I mentioned to you last time we had a chat, catch up, we've now launched the podcast, which we're well chuffed about, and it's branching out. We're going to be interviewing people from Chester and beyond, and it's a lifestyle podcast as well as looking at the arts, and it's cool. We decided to call it The Good Enough Human, with the premise being that some sort of psychologist years ago came up with the idea that you don't have to put yourself under pressure. As a parent, it was like a concept. You can be, just think of yourself as being good enough without thinking, oh, I've got to do it perfectly. So we've adapted that, and we thought, oh, I like that, The Good Enough Human. Bit of a lifestyle look. There's myself, Paul Crofts, Antonia Jones, Sarah Dine, and my good friend who's a musician, Stephen Kenyon Owen, doing some music for us and interviewing lots of different people. And we have the first episode where we introduced it, then we have the second one looking at meditation with a lovely lady called Chloe from Girl Meditates in Chester, which I think we all need, don't we, at this sort of time?
I think it will benefit from some meditation, definitely.
Oh, gosh, yes, I know I do. Mm. So, yeah, that's getting off the ground.
OK, that's good. So, The Good Enough Human, I'm just getting into... I know I'm late to the party, I'm late to every party, but I am just getting into finding podcasts and checking them out. So this is going on my list now, The Good Enough Human.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, it's available on iTunes and Spotify, Amazon Music, Podbean, the usual places, so we're well chuffed to get it onto there.
Well, that's great. And what, you're going to aim to do one a week, are you?
I think one a fortnight for the time being.
Okay, keep it realistic.
Yeah.
Fab.
Yeah.
All right, well, we'll check those out. But I know you're busy doing all sorts of other stuff as well.
Yeah, absolutely. My friend Matt Baker, one of our most talented musical theatre gurus in Chester, Matt Baker's been in touch to... tell me about a really, really important project.
He's always got a project on the go.
Oh, he's a busy guy.
In fact, he's normally got several projects on the go at the same time.
I don't know how he does it, honestly. Honestly, he's so busy. He's amazing. But he's launched an initiative with Theatre in the Quarter for young people, teenagers and children, because they've got their Quartz group for teenagers, Jigsaw for Young People.
Yeah.
And they've launched, they're recruiting members. They're going to do online get-togethers and do an online project called Dear Diary, or preparing to do a film project, I should say, safely, socially distanced. And it's all about looking at characters through time who've been trapped in one place. And as Matt said to me, you know, it's really important that young people and children get to do stuff like this when, you know, their lives have been disrupted, and it's pretty tough, it's pretty rotten at times. So things like this can be such a lifeline and give people, young people, a sense of community, as one of the young people who goes to Quartz said on a little video that Matt put together.
Well, I think this is so important anyway, but even, you know, more so now. You know, we're approaching the first year of lockdown, the first anniversary of a year in lockdown, and, you know, we mustn't underestimate what not going to school, what not socialising with their friends is doing to some young people. So the opportunity to get involved in a project like this is invaluable.
Oh, yeah, and I must stress, you don't even have to be from Chester. So if you're listening to this thinking, oh, I'm just over the border in Flintshire or something, then get in touch, you know. There's an email address, if I can just mention that.
Please do.
Lovely lady called Julie Elston, and the email is inquiries@theatreinthequarter.co.uk, and it's all over social media if you check out Theatre in the Quarter. And actually, if you want to do it old style, there's a mobile number, if I can mention that. 07747 110933, and they are such a lovely bunch of people that do incredible stuff, so I highly recommend that.
That's great, and I've written that down, so I'll read those contact details out again in just a few minutes.
Oh, fab.
What can you tell us about Tip Top?
Oh, yeah, Tip Top, even though the curtain's firmly down on the stages physically, they're still doing their lockdown season, which I think is ace, so innovative. They've got a Taskmaster night this coming Saturday night at 7 p.m., which is a free online event. and another new writing night coming up on the 16th of Feb, where it's a chance to either submit stuff, I guess, writing, or to listen in and enjoy it and socialise, because I know it's not quite the same as face-to-face, but I don't know about you, Gav, but I still do some Zoom gatherings, and I get a lot out of it.
I was just explaining to my mum last night how to do one.
Yeah.
Not how to do one, as in clear off, as in how to do a Zoom call. So she can chat to a few people on her newly purchased tablet. She's getting very, very down with the kids, you know. Soon she's going to know more about it than me, which is a bit frightening. Yeah. And I know that you want to mention the Cestrian Players, because you're involved with the Cestrian Players. So what's the latest project?
Yes, please. Chris Mapp, who's a local Chester-based writer, he's such a talented writer, and his latest production is a radio play called Cuts Throat Defence with some talented actors. Myself, not one of those.
I'm sure you are. Well, we'll find out when we watch it.
Absolutely. So we're in rehearsals for that at the moment, and it revolves around a group of wicked pensioners in Chester, and all sorts of dodgy stuff that they get up to, and we see whether or not karma and justice catches up with them.
Oh, we love a wicked pensioner.
Yeah, wicked pensioner.
I love a pensioner with a glint in their eye and, you know, having another go at just a bit of devilment here and there. You know, why not? It's never too late.
Absolutely, yeah. So that's going to be fun. It's fun in rehearsals. We've been laughing during our Zoom rehearsals. So.
Well, that's a good sign.
Yeah, it's going to be a good one. So look out for that on the Cestrian Players sort of YouTube channels and different social media channels.
So this is a radio play, so it's something obviously to listen to. We won't be able to... There won't be any video.
No, I think it's going to be radio play, but it might be put on YouTube. You know how they do these things.
Listen, there's nothing wrong with a radio play. Theatre of the mind.
It's good, isn't it?
Hasn't done the Archers any harm.
No, absolutely.
When's that going to be available, Angela?
Well, I think that's going to be available in the next month or two. We are just starting to record it, so that is going to be a lot of fun. And lots of local people in it.
What's it called again?
It's called Cutthroat Defence.
Cutthroat Defence.
It's an intriguing one. Yeah, Chris Matt, very talented. We've been chuckling out loud, so I hope anyone listening to it will get the same enjoyment.
Brilliant, thank you. And those details, once again, then, to get involved with the latest Quartz project is enquiries@theatreinthequarter.co.uk or phone 07747 110933.
Absolutely.
Fabulous.
Get in touch with them there.
Always good to have a cultural roundup with you, Angela. Thank you so much.
Oh, thanks for inviting me. Take care.
And
stay
you.
Safe.
Speak soon.
Bye.